computerized challenge match for the World Tag Team Championship. It is up for one fall, TV time remaining. First, the challengers, as selected by the computer. From Denver, Colorado, 231 pounds, two Cold Scorpio. And WCW Magazine Rookie of the Year, Marcus Alexander Bagwell.
Well, there they are, Eric Bischoff. Two of the contenders picked by the computer, I understand.
That's right.
Now what
I World Tag Team titles on the line, the computer challenge, and this matchup coming your way.
Hey, I like that little dance there. That wasn't bad.
This looks good doing that.
Their opponents, they are the World Tag Team Champions, the Hollywood Blondes.
Well, here they come, Eric Bischoff. The World Tag Team Champions, they rule the roost right now. Now, I got just a couple of little questions for you, Bischoff.
I'm ready.
I don't understand about everything I heard about this dadgum computer thing. How can it tell the heart of a man? How can it tell whether a guy's hurt or not? I mean, how do they judge that these guys are the best contender?
It's just like any other rating system that a computer uses. They factor in certain characteristics like speed, endurance, a one-loss record, experience, all those different variables and factors. The computer spits out the information and rates the various opponents, and thus you have the computer's contenders challenge. And that's what's coming your way. As I said, the World Tag Team title's on the line here in this contest. Of course, next weekend, they'll be on the line inside of a steel cage. But hey, the match is underway. This thing is going, but we have got to take a break. Blackjack, wolf down some chicken. We'll have the match. You're out of time. We'll be back in a moment. Welcome back to the main event. A lot of great action took place there during the break. Pillman was in the ring before we went to break. Now it's Bagwell and Austin. As Austin tagged in, this thing's going back and forth. A lot of
typical WCW action going on in that ring. There goes another tag. These guys know exactly what the concept of tag team wrestling is about, is keep a fresh partner all the time in there. But I just want to ask a couple more questions.
All right, go ahead.
How can you program in your computer tell desire? How do you know about desire? How do you know about intensity? How do you know about the will to win? Can you help me with that just a little bit?
No, I can't. That's one of the intangible elements of what makes up a champion, and certainly the computer can't measure that.
Yeah.
And that's the variable that makes this thing so exciting. Flying cross body block.
I understand that intangible drop kick there, Eric Bischoff. Intangible. That's what my first old lady was, you know. Claudine, she was intangible.
Two. I'm not going to touch that
Thank
with
you
a
very
10-foot
much.
Pole.
Same thing I told her. You know, well, here we go. Lots of action in the ring here, and I'm excited about this. I just kind of come. I just like to see one day this computer that can figure all this stuff out. But it looked like it did its work because the champs are having a pretty rough time here with these guys.
Well, you know, Pillman and Austin, they were real excited about the computerized contender challenge. They said, "Hey, we're the team of the 90s."
Wow, man, that's exciting. Well, he missed it. Wait a minute. Wait.
We
action
got enough
going
of
on. Exactly right.
What a
boot to the
man.
Man, that was an old West Texas boot right to the face, Eric Bischoff. I think that Scorpio and his partner Bagwell are, maybe they see, now the computer can't figure stuff like this out because these kids are probably performing at a higher level than the computer thought.
Well, there's a lot on the line right here, and of course, Slamboree coming up. So much excitement, so much at stake. And
well,
Pillman going to check out, but nobody there.
There's so much excitement going on inside
the
ring.
Look at this. Pillman is hot in Austin.
Hey, wait a minute now.
Uh-oh.
Hey. Now right here.
Trouble in Hollywood.
It's one thing you've got to have. They're arguing about something in there, Eric Bischoff. Boy, you've got to have continuity, and you have got to know who's behind your back. You've got to be backed up all the way by your partner.
I think that Dos Hombres have driven Pillman and Austin about half
the
crazy
who?
Here. Dos Hombres, you remember last week?
Exactly. Oh, I thought you were talking about a couple of guys I knew in Laredo, but those two guys, exactly, yeah. I know those guys. Yeah.
Irish Whip, too cold.
Whoa, what a maneuver.
Nice reversal, comes off the rope.
Beautiful
goes
maneuver.
Crucifix.
I love this stuff. Reminds me a lot of myself here at Big Top.
I never saw you move like that. Inside cradle. One, two again.
Boy, I'm going to tell you, a lot of movement in there. Scorpio's wild.
He is going after Austin.
I think they're giving the champs just a little bit more than they expected, because Scorpio and Bagwell are intent on winning this match. Up he goes.
There he goes. Scissors take down a tap, but Austin able to fight out of it.
A little mistake there. It's going to cost these guys. These guys got to get back to their continuity, get the flow of things going again. You know, some Arn Anderson, Barry Windham in Slammer 3. How about Davey Boy Smith and that big monster champ, Van Vader, there and there?
I tell you what, we heard from Davey Boy Smith last week on WCW Saturday Night. And as I pointed out, he is taking this injury to Cactus Jack, and we're still trying to find out the extent of that injury and what it's really going to mean to his career.
What's the deal with Cactus Jack?
Well, we don't know, but Davey Boy Smith has taken this thing very personally. And talk about personal. Look at
whoa, Too Cold. I think Too Cold took that a little bit personally. Whoa. This thing's starting to get out of hand in the ring there, Bischoff.
Hard not to take a chop to the top of the chest personally.
Look at these maneuvers. Boy, that is phenomenal movement, you know.
You ever do that?
Oh, yes. I love this stuff. This was really my forte, with a lot of head scissoring and quick movement and backflips and stuff. Ooh, especially at the rodeo, the Cacho Rodeo.
I was going to say, must have been in another lifetime.
Well, right, you ever rode a bull? You do a lot of flips riding
bulls.
Yeah. Well, oh, my gosh. Listen, he's got to be halfway decapitated after a move like that. Oh, my gosh. Had the same thing happen to me Saturday night about 2 a.m. one night. I missed the whole dadgum. Well, anyway, boy, it hurt.
And look at this crowd. They are responding to the action they are seeing here.
Well, they have reason to be, Eric Bischoff.
Tremendous action.
I mean, these young men, well, here comes Austin in.
Oh, Austin puts on the brakes. Says, no. But yeah. Bagwell levels him. Bagwell goes after Pillman, drops Austin with an elbow.
Well, the champs, I tell you something, they've got to get together here and get it all back. You know, wait a minute. Pillman's hot.
It's that towel again. Every week we've been seeing this with these little towels choking your opponents.
Exactly. I mean, you know, they had to get this thing back under control, because Bagwell and Scorpio, they were in danger of putting the champions out. Bagwell's in a little bit of trouble now. But, I mean, you know, Slamboree 93, a lot of the old-timers there. I'm excited. I'm going to be wrestling here at Big Top. I don't know if Ole Anderson's going to be wrestling, if Dusty's going to be wrestling. I just hope at the dinner that we have on Saturday night that the stuff don't get all messed up. Hey, he's got the towel again.
And I'll tell you what's going to get messed up is Bagwell, if he doesn't get away from that ring apron, is he'll get decapitated there with an elbow drop. And look at this. Get him out of here. Get rid of the towels.
Well, I mean, they've got the
towels. Actually, go on up there and grab that towel.
Well, just wait just a minute. I got some more to talk to you about. I mean, the champions, there's a lot of different ways and a lot of different methods to stay the champions. It looks to me like Pillman and Austin are showing a little bit of maturity on there. There's different ways to look at things, how to keep the title, and maybe one of them. I was always fair and square, though, myself.
Blackjack Mulligan, a true visionary.
Exactly.
A man who can see things that others can't in ways that others will never see them. Broadcast partner.
What does
He's
that
at
mean?
His seventh chicken.
What does that mean?
Two bottles of barbecue sauce. And look at Pillman now going after Bagwell. Bagwell spinning 180 right off the top. Cross body block. He's got it. Three, four. He should have had a four count.
What a forearm to the face here. This thing's getting so exciting, folks.
This time.
What a match.
Kick out. By Bagwell. What a tremendous match this morning here.
Sometimes, Eric Bischoff, I don't really understand what you're talking about over there, but I mean, you know, it's like predicting how much cotton can grow in Roscoe next year. I can see a lot of things. I mean, you know, a lot of things going on. I can see right now that the champs are in a lot of trouble, you know, and they better
it
go back.
It can never be like the Hollywood Boss.
Back it up.
Break it up.
Get him out of the corner. He's ripping away at his mouth.
I don't think they can be like the Hollywood Blondes either. I don't know if you'd want to be, but my favorites are the Hollywood Blondes. I like the champs. I like the guys. I like their chances. I don't care what mechanical thing. That's what bothers me. Computers is taking over this nation. They took over everything we're doing, and now they're taking over wrestling. So,
all right, now Austin
how's
is taking
the computer
going
to help him now?
Is not going to help him at all?
Yeah, maybe you better.
That was the point.
Maybe you better get something to dial in there. It's Q, champ.
Well, you don't need a computer to figure that one out. The program was real clear. Austin went airborne off the turnbuckle. Bagwell brought his knees up, and Austin goes after, in spite, Too cold. Cheap shot outside of the ring.
A lot of movement, excitement in the ring. Now they're going to some good old roughhouse tactics here. Fair and square stuff.
Fair and square.
You know, Bagwell, you know. Well, I tell you, they take you out back of the Rock Inn on Saturday night. And there's not a lot of fair and square rules out there. Toughest man survives, Bischoff. And you know what the toughest guy gets? He leads with the prettiest girl. The way it works where I'm from. I can't wait. I'm going to be sitting at Slamboree 93. I'm going to be watching Van Vader. I'm going to be, that is going to be one heck of a fight. I like Davey Boy Smith. Who are you voting for?
I tell you what, looking at the intensity in Davey Boy Smith's eyes and listening to the emotion in his voice.
Whoa, hey.
We may see a new world heavyweight champion.
Now, wait a minute now. Somebody just, did he just go over the top rope or not? Is my imagination.
Well, all I know is Bagwell right now is in a, he's in a lot of trouble. Whether he went over the top rope or in between the ropes doesn't really matter now. Referee didn't see it.
Well, it's very obvious that in the Wyndham Anderson match who I'm voting for, because I don't see that Anderson's going to do it, unless that creepy Ole shows his face or he pulls some tricks out of his bag. So, Wyndham a little bit of favorite in that match. What about the rest of the matches over there, Bischoff? How do you feel?
Well, of course,
who am I fighting? They won't tell me.
I don't know. I'm afraid. I'm hoping that it's not going to be someone in the broadcast booth, because I think you're determined to fight somebody.
Pass that sauce, will you?
Hold on, look at that. We got Austin.
Pass the sauce.
All right, here, hold on.
Get some more chicken over here. Anyway, abdominal stretch. He's got him stretched out there, and it's a very painful maneuver here. He's got to figure it out. There's only a couple of ways out of here. Telling everybody to be quiet, but I just can't see that happening right now.
But, you know,
now.
We're talking about all the great matches, and we can't forget it's just a little over a week away. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to see some of the greatest legends in the sport all in the same arena. But look at this, cheating again.
Just a little leverage. Guy needs a little leverage. He's wiping his face there. That's all he's doing. Exactly, folks. Seriously, you've heard me talk about it. Get mama from the kitchen, load them kids up, get to a TV set, because you're not going to get to see the great Gene Kaminsky, the Big Thunder. Mad Dog Michonne, my idol. I love Mad Dog Michonne, one of the meanest men in the world. A little trouble here. Bagwell's in trouble.
A lot of trouble here. Abdominal stretch and Bagwell trying to fight it off.
He has got to get out of that hold very quickly, because you stay there long enough, kind of just everything kind of gets stiff on you, cuts the circulation off. There we go.
Nice hip toss.
Now he's got to get that tag, Bischoff. He's got to get over there.
Oh, he's all torn up. He couldn't get to the corner.
I tell you what, these young
Austin
men.
Austin to the cover.
The champions are starting to show some maturity to me. They're getting some ring savvy in there now. How to run a tag team match. You've got to be the boss in there. And it's going to go a long way on who becomes the winner of this match, not letting Bagwell make that tag.
Absolutely. You know, you look at all the things that are on the line here with Austin and Pillman. Certainly, they're scheduled to put their world tag team titles up inside of a steel cage. They've got to be concerned about injury. Bagwell, too cold. They're scheduled to meet Eaton and Benoit. This thing is so important. The timing of this match, so critical to these athletes' careers.
Well, that cage thing, I'm going to tell you something. Putting your titles up in a cage, I've been in those things many times. You can just throw the rules out the windows, and you know, you can think about normal things starting to happen in the ring. Well, abnormal things happen in the cage. I mean, you never know what's going to come off. First of all, your partner gets thrown in the cage. He's hurt. He's bleeding. He's injured or something like that. You've got to continue on by yourself, and there's no way out. The factor that's removed is that you can't escape when you need a little rest. Take
short
a look at this.
Short clothesline by
so,
Austin.
I don't know who it's going to favor. Will it favor Austin or the other team?
Well, there's only one way to find out, and that's to be there when it happens.
Legends.
Pure and simple.
Slamboree 93. I'm so excited, folks. Don't miss it. Blackjack Mulligan will be there. Baron Von Reski, the Claw Man, going to be there, I understand.
And that is all the people need to know. The tag is made. It's too cold. Left, right, jump, spin, wheel kick. Jump side kick. Follows it up.
Definitely under control here. He's got everything going his way. He's got to be very cool, careful in these high maneuvers here. There's a lot of excitement. It looks like the computer team of Scarpio and Bagwell have everything, a very high risk move going on here. Got him. Come on,
he's got him.
Get over here,
one,
Red.
Two. Very short.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. The ref should have been paying more attention there.
Man.
What's wrong with this guy?
Come on.
Well, get a roll, boys. School up.
Two cards going at it again.
Oh, my goodness.
Short clothesline by Austin. Nine, he steals it. We're running out of time. Seven, television six, time limit here.
Four,
oh, come on.
Three,
man.
Pandemonium and excitement. Whoa, wait a minute. He just hit Austin. Hit his own partner. It's too late, brother. Too late. Woo.
Timing is everything, and theirs is bad.
I believe in the computers.